Yeah, discuss it. Okay, so I'll share my screen. So, I don't know where is the restroom, but I don't want to.
I'm saying why did they are not, I mean, aware of this class.
Okay. Okay, so today one. Okay, so today our topic is 2D array. So 2D array means it is array of arrays. So what is the meaning of this? Okay, so I will come this example, then again I will come with theory, because when we have to visualize this internal diagram, then we will understand how it is working. Okay. So actually, whatever the important topic is there for framework development, not only for framework, so that Java thing, and they will ask in the interview 90%, 80% Java question only. So that's why I am, you know, spending the time on the important topics and like use in the project and interview also. Okay, so this is okay. This is only one object I have created, so I'm not going here. So this is called your 2D array. So you can see we are using the two square braces. Okay, so that is called 2D array. So same thing yesterday we had discussed. So we will come in this part. So what is this part is there? So what happened? New. So new means one object is created. Internally, how this data will store. So new means one object is created here. Okay. Inside this, we have, you know, size 2, but here I am not giving anything. I will tell you the reason why I am not giving anything. Okay, so this is the dynamic, so I am not giving any value here. So what happened, one object is created and we have given the size 2 here. So again, what happened here, we have a size 2, so you know it will start from 0 end. Okay, so this is your 0, 1, 2. And one thing we can see, we can observe one more thing. This is called class type of an array. Okay, this is called class type of an array. So when you are creating anything, then what happens? The default value will be stored. So what is the class type? Class type means the default value will come, you know, object. What is the object default value? Null, right? So by default the value is null. This is the, you can tell, location null. So by default value is null. Why it is null? Because it is a class type. Class type an object. So object, what is the default value of an object? Default value of an object is null. Now I am going to store here. Okay, so this is your where is this? Yes, so this is, you know, this diagram, whatever the code we have written here, so we can internally this thing going to happen here. Now we are going to store inside this another array. So how to store this? So you can see this index A of 0, I have created the another array that is called, you know, I have given the size is 2. So this is your value now, understood, right? So why we are not giving this value? Because I don't know I am the users, and I don't know how many, you know, requirement is there, which requirement, you know, I have given the size is 2, someone will give the size is 3, someone will give the size is 5. So this is the, you know, using this second square braces, so this will give this the size, means which how many size of an array you are going to store, right? So a of 0, I'm going to store this. I have created another array type of an object and size I have given 2. So then what happened here? It will what happened here? We are going to store. So what happened here? Yeah, this object is created inside this object only, but here I don't have a space. So again, one object is created. Right? One object is created here. Okay. So when any object is created, one number is generated, right? Like I am taking this number that is called hash code. And now what is the size of 2, right? So here we have a size of here 2. Okay, 0, 1, 2. Here what it will store? It will not store this object, it will store here hash code. I am taking 0. Okay, so how internally it is going to store inside this? Now the size is 2, right? Here, okay, the size is 2. Again, in the index 1, I am going to store another array object. I have given the size is 3. Okay, here the default value is also null. Okay, a space is not there, just I am writing here null default value. Again here I am going to store another array object. So one object is created, size is 3. Okay, just take the screenshot of this diagram, so when you will revise, that picture will come in your mind. Okay, because in the notes I did not make this diagram. Okay, so now again here one hash code is there, this object hash code. Just I am taking the random number, okay, but just random number is generated for your understanding purpose. 2, 2. So what happened? Null will replace with 2, 0, 2, 0. Here default value is here 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 2, right? I think size is 2, 0, 1, 2. It will go till it won't be go because size is 2, no? Then size is 2 only, it will go for 0, 1, right? Not 2. Okay, so don't confuse. Okay, so size is 3 and 2, then 0, 1. It won't be go 0, 1, 2, okay? I did not see this, so this is, you know, wrong. So size is only 3 here. 0, 1, 2 only, okay? So here, null. Okay, null. So it value will store here. I think you will get some idea. Internal diagram of 2D array. Right? So this is, you know, when you are writing the code of 2D array, so this thing will happen. So we have a concept called data provider in Selenium. So, you know, that data provider, we are reading the data from the Excel, right? So in the Excel, what happened? It is the row and column. So here is also showing this row and column. So I will teach you this 2D array. I have given this concept why? Because we will use in the Selenium. When you will print this value, then it will come only hash code only, right? You know, this is the hash code only. So when I will compile this, so this is a simple diagram of this, okay, 2D array. So this hash code we are going to print here, that's it. So how internally working? So we will apply this 2D concept in the Selenium. In Selenium we will explore this. So that's why in the definition I have written, in the point I have written, it is array of arrays. The main advantage of this approach is memory utilization will be improved. That's why we are using this 2D array. Okay. One more concept is there, that is called anonymous array. Okay. So this is called nameless array or called anonymous array. Okay, and array object without any reference is called anonymous array. So yesterday we had discussed one more point, right? So array you can use like that also. Okay. like that you can use, and A of 0 you can store the value, right? 4 or A of, I'm not writing to, just I'm showing how many types you can create an array and where you will create an array, okay? So which syntax and where you will use to create an array. I think my light power is gone. Okay, 1 second. Hello. Okay, so how we have a different type of syntax of an array. Okay, so this is the one type, and when we will use this type, this syntax, when we have a, you know, size of, you know, size, we have already the size, you know, how many size of an array we have to store the value. So that when you have a before implementation of your requirement, you have before the, you know, size of an array, then we will use. We don't have how many value you want to store, then we will use this index. So like by any value. Now we have, if someone wants to, you know, reinitialize this syntax, if you want to reinitialize this syntax like A, and I want to reinitialize like anything 10 11. Okay, so what happened if I will compile this, then what happened, we will get error here. Okay, sorry, 1 second, I have not given this. So when we are using this type of, you know, syntax, okay, so we cannot reinitialize this. So that one more concept is there, that is called anonymous array. So by using this anonymous array, we can, you know, do this you can reinitialize. And when we are using the parameterized concept, in like I have a code, but I don't have in this notes. If I implement, it will take too much time, so I will tell you. Okay, like I have one requirement, you have to make the functionality, you have to remove duplicates element inside this array. Then how to make this functionality? Functionality means we are not going to do hard coded. Okay, and that logic we have to use inside another project also. Then how to make it this? I'm not writing this complete code, just I will tell you how to make the functionality. So I have to make one functionality, right? White, okay, and I'm taking this public static white. Just I am showing where we will use nameless array, anonymous array. Okay, so just I am giving one idea. Okay, now I have given this array A here. Okay, so now my requirement is, yeah, I have to use this logic inside this in our project. Okay, so how to make the functionality? So I made this a static method. Inside this static method, you can see, just I'm not writing complete code, just I am showing you where you will use this anonymous array. Okay, so this parameters I take this, you know, parameter here, one input. Yeah, in technical language it's called parameters. So this is the array, right? We are not going to do hard coded here. According to, we will call the method and we can initialize this concept. So here we have to write the logic. You have to, you know, here logic is there. We have to remove the duplicates element inside this array, right? So like that we are writing the logic here. Okay, I'm not writing complete logic, just I am showing you, okay? Might you, I will use one more loop. So I will tell you, I think if I will get the time, I will give you the logical class also. But I made it this video because of, I think I have already told you, just follow that video, I have already explained it. Just one logic. Now, you cannot change again and again, right? Here, then what happened? It is a hard coded. Now this logic I have implemented. And now how to use this method? Simply we will call this method, right? M1. Okay, so we will call this method and inside this main method. Now here, if you, then again you have, how we will give the argument here? We will not write like that. Otherwise there is no need to pass this argument, right? If I will use like that, so again one more steps we have to do. There is no need to again pass this parameter because again we are doing the same step, right? So here we will use nameless array that is called anonymous array. Okay, so like that, if you will initialize like that, this, once again, this one. Okay, so this is called anonymous array. No one will ask in the interview. They will ask what is an array, that's it. Sometimes they can ask 2D array, but they will not ask. They will ask only what is an array. Okay, it is a homogeneous, heterogeneous, and they will ask the logical question in the array concept. They will not go internally, hey, where we are using, how many types of an array, how, what is the syntax of an array, where we are using an array. So they will not ask. So here we will use this, okay, nameless array, that is called anonymous array. Okay, so I'm not going to very deeply in this because not required for this, just I have told you where we will use of three syntax of an array. Okay, so nameless array are called anonymous array. An array object without any reference is called anonymous array. Two definitions, same. Okay, this is the syntax of anonymous array. We are not using, you know, reference here. Okay, so this is a 1D and this is a 2D. Okay, one more concept is there inside this. So last session I had discussed, we cannot give the size as a, you know, a double and float. Okay, but we have a concept called casting. Okay, so when we are giving the size of 3.6D, that is called D means double type. Okay, this is called literals. Okay, literals, F means float type. If you will give the variable, if you have a variable and if you will give this F, L, D, so these are called literals. So F means float type, L means double type, D means, sorry, L means long type and D means double type. So I have created class type of an array, means test demo array. Then I have given the size only. If I will compile this, then what happen? Sorry, I did not say this class. Okay, so if I will compile this and see what will happen. Okay, so you can see what error is coming here. Incompatible type lossy conversion from double to int. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? We cannot give the size as a double or float. Okay, but you can do this double type, we can convert into the integer type. So this is called casting. So how to cast? So this is called casting symbol of, this is casting symbol, parenthesis open and close parenthesis. Okay, if I will execute this, so now if I am going to try to execute, so now the double type is converted into the integer type. Okay, just I have to comment this, otherwise this line will execute, then compiler will find the error here one. So our program is terminated here, it won't be go here. Okay, so that's why that error is coming. upstairs. I commented this line again. I was executing this. So I'm able to compile this. Just I'm not just execute this. So we are not getting any error. Okay. So this in this example we learn if we have a double type in size of an array, but if you will compile without casting, then you will get error. Then we can do by using this casting. Okay, so we have converted into integer type. Okay, so this is the one example of this. One more example here also we will learn something. Just I'm copy here only, and one example I one class I will show again. I have to save this class. So one more thing, you can do initialization, reinitialization of an array. So we have a char type of an array. Inside this we have a character type. What I did here, this char type, I have a store inside C, and this C I'm going to reinitialize the C1. Okay, so this value will be stored inside this C1. So we can do also reinitialization. Okay, so now we are getting this value ABCD, right? So we can do this also. Some possibility I have given here. One more possibility is there. So if you know Java concept, then you can give the answer of this. So my question is, so this is another concept, and this concept is very important. Okay, my question is, if I will, we have a char array ABCD, and I am going to compare this reference variable C equal to D. The value will come, this is called assignment operator, right? Double equal operator. So this double equal operator is returning boolean type, means it will return true or false. My question is, it will return true or false?
Hi Mohit, I think this is the false, because they are to make to differ in hash code number.
Okay. Oh yeah. So it is not comparing this content. Okay, it is comparing this reference variable. Okay, so we have a another concept called equals method. You know equals method? What is the equals method?
Yeah, equals ignore. They are going to like compare the instance of the variables like ABC.
Okay. I think I will give you some overview of a string also. Okay, coming classes. So in big days, might be I will take we are 2 and 3 days, whatever the time we will get, I will take your Java class, and coming weekend I will start Selenium. Okay, so whatever the topic you have a problem in the Java, let me know, I will give you the time. Okay, and Selenium I will start as soon as possible. Okay, so we are not coming this completely equals method, because this is again big topic. So simply we will just remember this. Here it is not comparing this content of an array. Here we are comparing this hash code. So what happened? This reference variable will, you know, this reference variable, it is comparing the reference variable. Reference variable means hash code. Hash code, you know, we have a one method that is called hash code. So by, you know, how to display explicitly hash code. So we have a hash code is a method. So object class, you know, inside this object class, we have a default method. We have a to string, we have a equals method, we have a hash code method. Okay, so another method is also there. So these methods are we are using frequently. Okay, so if I will compile this, okay, I think I executed this. So it is comparing the hash code, it is not comparing the content. So you can see we have a different number. So this number they are comparing, so that's why the value is coming false here. Okay. So we have a type, array type, and allowed element. So we are not going to learn this completely, but two things we have to know. Primitive data type. So in the primitive type array, only primitive type is you can store. So same thing I have written here. Any type which can be explicitly promoted to the declare type. So primitive type you can store. Okay. Object type of an array. So inside this object type you can store any type. So I will after this session I will start collection. So in the collection I will show you this object class. I will give you the example of the object class also. So why the collection comes in this Java concept. So we will execute the code and we will show you what is the disadvantage of an array. So that's why the collection comes, and the in the object the frequently we are using the collection. Okay, so either declare type or its child class object. Okay, so we have a abstract class type and interface type of an array. So this point is not required, so leave it this. Array variable assignment. Okay, so here you can learn one more concept here. So element level promotion are not applicable at array level. Okay, so first I will show you this, then I will come with theory, because you are not able to understand. Actually, in the there are two data types, right? One is your a simple primitive data type, one is your array type or class type, right? So we have some difference between primitive data type and array type or class type array. Okay, so this thing I am going to, you know, I have given the example. Char element can be promoted into the int type, means in the character, simple character data type you can store the int type, but in this char array type you cannot store int type of an array. So this is the difference. So this difference I will show you in this code. Okay, so this difference I will show you here. So what is the difference I want to tell you here? We have a one type, you know, int type of an array. We have a character type of an array. So what I am going to do here, I am going to we can do this, right? Because in the last example we can do a character, you know, a type, a reference variable, and we are going to store inside this b. Okay, so this array element will be stored inside this b. So it is possible if I will compile this. So coming example, I will also show you how it is reinitializing. I'm not going to print, so it is applicable. Now this is fine. You can store int type of an array inside this another, you know, int type of an array. But if you are trying to store this one, this is the int type an array, I am going to store char type, then what happened? We will get compiled an error. Okay, so it is not applicable. So incompatible type, char cannot be converted into the int. Okay, but in the simple data type, means primitive data type, it is possible. But in the array, it is not possible. So this point I have mentioned in the notes only. If I will compile this, so you can see, I'm going to compile, I'm going to execute. Okay, so that point I have mentioned. That is the another concept. So what is applicable, what is not applicable, I have mentioned. So if you will store int in the char, it is applicable. So it is true statement. You want to store int into the char, it is wrong statement. Double to int you can store, double to int you can't store. Long to float you can't store, and long to array, long array and this plot you cannot store this. So this is sometimes they can ask in the multiple choice. Okay, that's it. Okay, so I think this is not related for array concept. So one more concept is there. In case of object type array, child class type array can assign into the parent class type of an array reference. So what is the meaning of this? What is the supermost class in the Java? Inside in Java we have a supermost class object class. If you are creating any class, that class is the child class. Super class, supermost class in the Java is the object class, which is already inherit. Okay, it is not showing, but by default it is inherit. So what is the point I have mentioned here in my this edit plus this object class is not working, but in your system you can try to this code will work. Okay, it will compile and it will execute. So what point I have mentioned here, just will again we will go, in case of object type array, child class type array can be assigned to the parent class type of an array. So a string is also class, right? So but the child, this is the child class of object class, or you can tell it this is the subclass of object class, because the sub object class is the supermost class. So the subclass reference variable you can store in the parent class reference variable. In my system having some issue with this object class, okay, so that's why it is not execute, but in your system it will work. Okay, try in the Eclipse. If I will open the Eclipse, it will take time. Okay, so what you have to, just it is applicable, try in your system, it will work. Okay, so this is the another concept. Okay, so we have a one more concept. So this is already we have learned. Okay, but again I am going to execute this. Whenever we are assigning one array internally, element won't be copied, just reference variable will be reinitialized, and hence size are not required to match, but type should be matched. So what is the meaning of this? Again I will come with this theory. So what happened, you can how to do the reassignment like that. So same thing when this thing we are using with the simple data type, means primitive data type. Okay, so now you can see here we have a one array that is called A and we have a B. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to do reinitialization. So this A type I have a store inside this B. Okay, this, so inside this B I have a stored this value. Okay, so all this element will copy it inside this B. So now the what is the value of, if I will print this B value, then what is the value will come. So if I will execute this, so see the what the value is coming. Okay, so now I'm going to, so you can see inside this A means the variable we are going to reinitialize. So what happened, it copied all A element, it is copied inside this B. Okay, so same thing I applied here also. Just I'm going to comment this, otherwise some confusion will come. So now in this example I did same. Okay, okay, so now we have a A. In this B I am going to store inside A. So this all the value will store inside this A, right? So this is called reinitialization. Okay, so now we are getting this 70 or 80. I think this is the last topic of an array. So one thing actually, light is not